You know, I wish I can combine certain elements of weapons together to make them into one. 180 round per minute hand cannons are not meta, but some of them feel phenomenal. Most recently, we reviewed Nature of the Beast. It had a very nasty roll on it, quick draw rangefinder, and despite the time to kill on that weapon being a whopping 1 second, it still hung with the best of them. No, it's not meta. Yes, I had to work for my kills, but for the most part, it felt amazing. Aikalos, well, this handgun is a little different. It does not feel good. It feels sluggish as hell. It doesn't necessarily have good damage dealing perks for PvP. Its reload speed, although not as bad as Nature of the Beast, is still pretty awful, with a base default magazine size of 9. But boys, it doesn't sound good. There's one key component, though, about these Aikalos weapons that does give it somewhat of an edge, and that is the beautiful Seraph rounds. Seraph rounds, just like on our other Aikalos weapons, boost the range of the weapon, approximately like 2.5. For Aikalos's case, about 3 meters, which is pretty significant. We're talking this hand cannon right here with a ranged masterwork as well as a barrel perk boosting range, giving us a damage falloff range beginning at 13 meters. Yeah, if only 180s were actually good. Today, guys, we're going to go through a number of roles today, talking about Aikalos in both PvP and PvE, where this weapon shines, and what you should be hunting down for this season. And by the way, let me just mention, this is going to be a very long season. I kind of been going into each season with this temporary mindset, like, all right, we've got artifact mods, 2 to 3 months, couple mods here and there for just a short duration, and then boom, we're in the next season. But considering that this season is being stretched all the way to November 10th, well, fellas, we better get cozy, because what we got is what we got. Now, my role on this Aikalos weapon was okay. It came with chamber compensator, extended mag, which bumped the magazine size from 9 to 12, triple tap, and rampage. Now, to be honest with you, this is actually a really good role for PvE. Although, I think I would still take something over extended mag, maybe tac, pendant mag. Extended mag takes that reload speed of what, 40? And drops that thing down to 23. It has got to be the longest reload animation I have ever witnessed. On a rapid fire weapon that is obviously going to blow its load very quickly in comparison to other hand cannons. It kind of blows my mind that Bungie comes out here and gives us such an abysmal reload speed. I'm talking the second coming of Jesus Christ will occur before you reload this weapon. But one saving grace about this role is triple tap. The ability to pull ammo from thin air. As long as your landing precision hits, you can do that. And of course, rampage is amping that damage up with each consecutive hit, thus resulting in more one-hit kills if landing crits. So it's got a place. It extends its lethality there for a little bit longer. And on top of that, remember, the biggest selling point to Aikalos weapons is the fact that they spawn Warmind cells. And like I said, we've got this season from now until November. Warmind cells are very much a part of our lives. It's here to stay, boys. And I honestly think that Bungie's going to elaborate more on it in the seasons to come, although I would love to see them say something about it. And that was role number one. Role number two. We had to dig deep in our Discord to find this one. Shout out to Kat for some excellent RNG. This role is the ideal role for PvP, or what we thought to be the ideal role. First up, it comes with Hammerforge Rifling, which does increase the range without hurting any of your other stats. I like it more than full bore, especially on such a slow handling weapon like this one. Through the draw time on this thing, right? Your opponent can kill you, bag you, and emote you all in the same time frame that it takes for you to pull out this hand cannon. So don't hurt that handling speed, whatever you do. The second perk on it is Seraph Rounds, which we just established boosts our range here on this hand cannon by 2.5 to 3 meters. Very nice. The only downside of Seraph Rounds is that it's present in the magazine column, thus meaning we're not taking advantage of something that boosts the magazine size. And let me tell you, fellas, 9 rounds really sucks on a 180 hand cannon. Like, I don't really understand the mindset, because it's going to take at least 4 shots to get a kill. On average, 5, putting you in a situation that after every gunfight, you will have to sit down and watch that slow reload speed over and over again. Now, to rectify this issue, we tried combining it with Slideways. Now, Slideways is not Slideshot. Slideways boosts the handling and stability, which on this 180 is incredibly nice. Slideshot boosts range, right? I don't know if I would have preferred Slideshot or Slideways. I kind of wish it would have came with Slideshot, just so I can see, all right, how far can we go with it? 31 meters, maybe 32 meters before reaching damage fall off when Slideshot is procced. The downside of Slideways as well as Slideshot, it only loads 2 rounds in the magazine when you slide. Yes, you still get these benefits, increased stability, increased handling, but it's 2 rounds. In the grand scheme of things, does it help? Yes. Will you find yourself in situations where you're trying to reproc Slideways mid-gunfight and it's on its cooldown and then you die? Absolutely. That's the problem with it. Pretty much put this in your head. It takes every third slide slide to reproc slideways. So you proc slideways, then you have to do 3 slides. Every 3rd slide will reproc it if you do it in a row. Now the final perk in this column is Rampage. Rampage is nice, but it does not make that big of a difference for PvP. Really, the damage dealing perks you want for PvP on a 180, considering that they only do 57 damage per crit and 39 damage per body, you want kill clip or at least multi-kill clip. Because ideally what you want to do is you want to lower that default time to kill value of 1 second to that crispy Lunas Howl not forgotten time to kill value from way back when of 0.67 seconds. But you can only do that with a damage dealing perk like kill clip or multi-kill clip. One stack of Rampage does throw our damage up. It says 63, but it's like 62.5 or 0.7, somewhere around that mark. There's some rounding of numbers, but it can get the 3 tap, but only on Guardians like 1, maybe 2 resilience or less with 1 stack of Rampage. Whereas something like kill clip completely overloads the weapon and allows for more consistent 3 taps, and it's just easier to manage. And I was rocking things like Rampage Spec here, trying to make the weapon a little more of a chain kill from target to target. But even with something like Slimeways, I found myself constantly having to reload, which is just so annoying. Overall, I think this role did good, but to me, Aikalos just doesn't have a place inside of PvP, which is kind of a shame. And we play with a controller here as well as mouse and keyboard. The problem is that it doesn't have any major damage dealing perks, but we looked at Nature of the Beast and neither does Nature, right? The difference between Nature and Aikalos is probably due to the fact that Nature can roll with Quick Draw and the weapon just doesn't feel like a sluggish 180, right? You're able to evade that. On top of that, you can roll things like Rangefinder on that hand cannon. It feels phenomenal. It feels really, really good. Aikalos here doesn't have that same feel, on top of having a worse base magazine size. Honestly, what I wish we could do is put Seraph rounds on some of our other weapons. But I know Bungie wouldn't do that. They purposely only put them here on our Aikalos weapons to give these weapons a little more value and edge. Inside of PvE though, guys, I would say Aikalos is a decent choice. But to be honest with you, the only reason why I would choose Aikalos is only if I was actually trying to rock a Warmind build and I was simultaneously trying to get a Void Burn on one of my weapons. That's it. Everything that this weapon does, honestly, the Aikalos SMG does better. And I know that's an SMG. I'm just saying, if I was to go in there and say, hey, I want to rock a Warmind build, I would hands down use the Aikalos SMG over the Aikalos hand cannon, unless, of course, I was looking for a Void Burn. On the other side of things, hand cannon to hand cannon, I think the 7th Seraph Officer is a better hand cannon than the Aikalos hand cannon. I think it feels way better. It's got a better default reload speed. It, too, can also spawn Warmind cells. The only difference is that it's present in the kinetic slot instead of the energy slot. And depending on what you're going against, that may or may not be beneficial for you. I do find it strange that we have 2 180 round per minute hand cannons here that both can spawn Warmind cells and are tied to Rasputin in some way. So guys, that is our review there for the Aikalos hand cannon. If you really want to make this weapon work, I would highly advise, considering how abysmal that reload speed is, rocking something like Marksman Dodge for my Hunter, Transversive Steps on my Warlock, or if you're a Titan, I was actually rocking Bottom Tree Striker, taking advantage of both Frontal Assault and Knockout, as well as Insurmountable Skull Fort. And every time I had to reload, I would just get a melee kill off, proc the increased damage there with Frontal Assault, and instantly reload my weapon. Something to keep in mind, guys. If you're going to utilize this weapon, make life easier on yourself, because again, you will claw your eyes out watching this thing having to reload. And in the least, just use an enhanced hand cannon reloader. But even then, it's still slow. Fellas and ladies, thank you all for coming and watching. And as always,
slap that like button like your mama told you right.